Hello YouTube, Salivate Metal here with a sobering reality from an event that took place on Friday the 21st of October 2016 that it was essentially politically motivated. A massive denial of service attack has occurred on the United States and the West, especially in the UK and the like, and other areas. And it's quite fascinating. This has to do with the WikiLeaks and the internet being cut off at the Ecuadorian embassy to where Julian Assange resides. And apparently many different networks and websites were affected by this outage. And it just goes to show you how delicate the network and the internet really is, and how much we rely on it. Even if you don't think you rely on it, it's pretty fascinating indeed. And this story here from the dailymail.com, which is an excellent website for news, it's very thorough in its reporting. And but here is a tweet from WikiLeaks basically saying that Mr. Assange is alive and well, and WikiLeaks is still publishing. We ask supporters to stop taking down the U.S. internet. You proved your point. So there you have it. It just goes to show you how vulnerable our network is, and how important it is to be prepared for times like these, when it could have been much worse and lasted for much longer if it really wanted to. This denial of service attack was done in response to, as I mentioned earlier, what is thought to be a U.S. involvement in shutting down the internet from the Ecuadorian embassy to Julian Assange's residence. And so this is a revenge, or a response to that, considering all the numbers of emails that have come forward. And so there's that statement, and then here's another statement, a follow-up statement from WikiLeaks, accusing the Obama administration should not have attempted to misuse its instruments of state to stop criticism of its ruling party candidate. So quite fascinating indeed. So there you have it. It's quite, and then there's some fears that this could happen again on election day. And so who knows where things could lead, because obviously the elections are becoming more dependent on the internet as well for reporting and for the different levels of taking information in. Of course, we all vote. There's different options typically to vote, either manually by hand, or marking on a Scantron sheet, or an electronic voting method. But that information has got to be transferred, and it's got to go through some sort of conduit. And in that conduit, could it be shut down? Who knows? Could it be compromised? Who knows? It was essentially described as a very sophisticated and complex attack that affected many smart home gadgets. So many, many places, many things that run on the internet at home affected by this. And as we get more reliant on the internet, these things are going to have a greater effect, I think. So post your thoughts below. It's quite fascinating and quite a wake-up call, I think, on various different levels. I'll post a link to this article in the description below. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I'd like to extend the multitude of gratitude to you all for watching, and encourage you to please rate, comment, and subscribe.